Yeah. You love me, alright. You love putting cigarettes out on me. Or giving me bruises every day after school. Of turning mom against me too. Telling her own son didn't love her. I suffered 16 years of physical abuse from that prick. To scare them straight, fuck all these new age orders. The more you hit them, the more they listen. But I listened, and he still fucking hit me. Mum, she didn't even care, man. She was an empty shell after what he did to her. It was worse when he was drunk. And he was always drunk. Mark Bosco Ledley. Bosco the bookie, they used to call him. Dodgiest man this side of the Shannon. He was always a perfect stranger to me. I never knew who he was. He was also perfect gentleman, the strangers. Always getting in the rounds. And then he came home and he did 10 fucking rounds of me. It was like a national holiday when he wasn't drinking. Why? The beatings weren't as bad. It was almost like he didn't enjoy it when he was sober. He never hit me in the face though, drunk or sober. It was almost like he knew. He covered his tracks. The beatings were to make me a man, he said, not like the other pussies he saw around town. I had no money, I was half starved. Mum drank, he drank the rest. I always was a kip. I thought maybe if I got out of school and got a job, I'd get Mum over there. Mum found a lover. A woman. Could you blame her after living with a man for 80 years that didn't know how to be one? She told him everything. The only brave thing she ever did in her life, and he beat her so badly for it. The only beatings he gave her weren't as bad as mine. She broke him that day. He broke every bone in her face and punched all the teeth out of her fucking head. I didn't recognize her. It'd be the only thing she could cling on to her was her looks. She looked like an old woman covered in blood. I found him drunk in his chair. As if nothing happened. I walked up to him. I punched him in the face as hard as I could. I heard his nose crack on the impact. That fucker. I got a brutal beating that day. I knew it was all ending. And the punishment was going to stop that day. What I didn't know was how bad the curtain call was going to be. trying to slash my face. I weaved all the way in time after that scar there. When he finished with me, he said, "If I ever see you again, I'm gonna fucking kill you. And that's a promise." I didn't see him again in the flesh until 4 months ago. I didn't then fulfill that promise.